The words virtual and virtualization are popular these days. From virtual worlds and virtual reality to application-level virtual machines like Dalvik or Java's virtual machine, what we are concerned with here are virtual platforms. And by platform, we mean an operating system running on top of some hardware. Let's say Alice has her own company, Alice Inc., and she has some cool applications to run for productivity. And let's say that they're running on a Windows machine on some server that the company maintains. Now, if cost were not an issue, then this will be the ideal situation for Alice Inc. The hope of virtualization is that we will be able to give a company, perhaps not as well endowed as Alice Inc., let's say Bala Inc., almost the same experience that Alice Inc. gets at a fraction of the cost. So instead of a real platform that Alice Inc. has, Bala Inc. gets a virtual platform. Now in this diagram, what I've shown you is a black box to represent the virtual platform. Because so far as Bala Inc. is concerned, they don't really care what goes on inside this black box. All they want is to make sure that the apps that they want to run can run on top of this virtual platform. In other words, as long as the platform affords the same capabilities and the same abstractions for running the applications that Bala Inc. wants, he's happy. Now we, however, as aspiring operating system designers, are very much interested in what goes on inside this black box. We want to know how we can give Bala Inc. the illusion of having his own platform without actually giving him one and incurring all of the cost, the implementation and maintenance associated with implementing such a virtual platform.